guys, I'm Allie. Thank you for tuning into my channel. So starting this gardening series has really been more about just learning how to garden, but also learning about the names of the flowers and the plants, learning a little bit more of their background and how to care for each of them. The more I do my research, the more I realize that there is so much to know. I know I'll never become an expert overnight, but this is all for fun, and it's just to spend time outside and to experiment with my new hobby. So today I want to take you guys on a flower garden tour from how everything has been growing from May until how they look today. Every day it seems like there's something new that's growing, and there's so much I need to catch you guys up on. So I may have mispronounced a few names of these flowers, but I've learned so many new interesting facts about each of them, and y'all know how I love nerding out from time to time. Normally we would have so many guests over at our house to go tour the garden with, but this year is a little bit different. But I think it's still a pretty neat way to tour the garden virtually with you guys to share some natural beauty with you. Hopefully I can share some new information I've learned from my research, and hopefully it'll inspire you guys to maybe pick one of our flowers that you'll have in your own garden one day. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I know Leo did. So let's get growing! Alrighty, to begin today's garden tour, we'll start with one of our first flowers that bloomed this year, tulips. Teresa planted roughly 150 bulbs in the fall in three of our flower beds. We have a mix of big and small tulips, however they only last a few weeks, but it adds so much color to the garden as everything else comes back to life in the spring. These big layered yellow tulips are called Charming Beauty tulips. They look so exotic and have the lush look of peonies. These purple and pink tulips were growing in the bed at the front of the house. Unfortunately, they were only blooming for a week or so because we had massive rain showers, sleet, and cold temperatures that destroyed all of our flowers that bloomed early. This beautiful yellow-flowered spring blooming shrub is called a Japanese caria. It's part of the rose family and is native to Japan, China, and Korea. Sadly, this is another flower that succumbed to our last cold frost of the season. There will still be some flowers blooming throughout the summer, but it's just not going to be as full as it was in the early spring. This here is a clip I took after the storm. No more colors in this bed except the lush greenery of our foliage. We're sad to see them go so soon, but at least we got to enjoy them for a short time. On the side of the house, the oddly shaped flowers of the bleeding hearts are blooming all over our garden, and they'll be here for several weeks. And soon, the shrub filling up the space in between, the Japanese spirea, will be covered with dainty pink blossoms that cover the dark and dense foliage. These popular little blue flowers are widely known as forget-me-nots, otherwise known as scorpion grasses. According to my research, they symbolize true love, and by giving someone this flower means that you truly love them and you respect this person. How cute! Shown here are the peonies in May. The blossoms haven't formed at this point, however, support posts were added early on before they grew too big as the flowers were extremely heavy when they bloom. When peonies form their blossom, I noticed that they were covered in ants. Being the curious person that I am, I had to do more research as to why they do this. Turns out, the peonies' buds are oozing nectar. The ants don't damage the bud, but in fact they defend the plant from any attacks from harmful sap-sucking, petal-chewing insects. This relationship is temporary, and when the bloom opens, the ants will move on to find a new home. It's amazing to see these buds that are so small when they're growing, but when they bloom, they grow into huge layered flowers in bright colors. I believe we have three different colors of peonies in our garden. I love when they begin to open up and you can see what color they're going to be. Sadly, peonies only flower for a short time, around 7 to 10 days, but the beauty it brings to your garden is like no other. Each plant will give multiple blooms, so there's plenty to share with friends, and having fresh cut bouquets inside to enjoy is completely worth it to me. The pink flower is by far my favorite flower that grows in our garden, aside from my beloved sunflowers. Now on to the hillside garden bed. This bed is a sunny and dry area that houses mostly drought-tolerant plants. It has a lot of different types of ground cover plants, a few lavender varieties, and some of our peonies live here. The flowers that require extra watering get special hydration in the mornings or the evenings. Our newest addition, commonly known as the prickly pear,
or the Opuntia cactus, is identified by their wide flat pads. They are extremely drought tolerant, so this bed is perfect for them. In most areas, rainfall will be enough to sustain established plants like this one here. We plan on removing some other ground cover in this area and growing more of these spiny cacti. Ah, yes. The snow in summer. This perennial evergreen carpets the ground with the grayish silvery foliage that blooms white flowers from late spring to early summer. This ground cover plant is low growing and it's the perfect choice to add to garden borders as it adds a pop of white when it's in bloom. It thrives in this bed as it prefers dry and sunny areas. I've actually seen a picture online of someone replacing their whole lawn with this plant. Personally, I think I'd still choose green grass. Now I think it's time to showcase the iris. This popular flower is beloved by many gardeners, and they're known for their colorful blooms. The name of the flower originates from Greek mythology, derived from the Greek word for rainbow. Interestingly enough, there are about 250 to 300 species of the genus Iris. There are so many different types and colors available, but my personal favorite is the light blue iris, which we don't have in our garden yet. In our garden, I believe there are about 6 different types. They bloom best in full sun, and without enough light, they simply will not bloom. For us, we love how they look bunched up and scattered around the garden beds. These flowers are fragile, and they can break easily in stormy weather, so we lost a few of our bigger blooms early on. Irises multiply fairly quickly, but can become overcrowded, but they're pretty easy to divide. The best time to transplant iris is in the summer, after they finish blooming, up until the fall. We are looking at changing the layout of some of our irises this year, so perhaps we'll feature that project in one of my future videos. The bugs love them, we love them, everybody loves them. They're definitely a top choice if you're looking to add some color to your gardens. Now let's head into the front yard where we have ferns, shrubs, and flowers mixed into one big bed. This unique blue flower growing here is known as the Centura montana, or the mountain cornflower. It's a perennial plant that has fringed bright blue blossoms that attract butterflies and bees like a magnet. This plant is native to the mountains of Central and Southern Europe, growing like a wild weed in the meadows and woodlands. This plant loves sunny areas, but I've experimented with it by planting some in the shady area near my bedroom window. This flower is personally one of my favorites because of the bright colors and the funky shape it has. Plus, it adds some flair to my bouquets. After the flower blooms and it looks like the flower is drying up, cut the base of the plant 2 inches above the ground and this flower will bloom for another cycle near the end of the summer. In the same garden bed previously mentioned, we have a Japanese lilac bush at our entrance that produces a strong, sweet fragrance from its delicate flowers. These tall pom-pom looking purple and white ornamental bulbs are called alliums. They are a perfect addition to any perennial garden. They grow fast, require low maintenance, and they're relatively hardy. They need full sun and good drainage, however they aren't too picky. We have alliums pop up in different places around our garden because of the squirrels moving the bulbs around. In our garden, we have light purple, dark purple, and white blooms that flower in the spring and the summer. After flowering, trim the stalks down to allow the plant to focus on restoring its energy in the bulb. The next feature plant on our tour was very challenging to identify as it looked extremely similar to another shrub. After comparing the two and doing my research, I discovered that this one's called a weigela. In the spring, it bursts into bloom with pretty tubular flowers. This deciduous shrub prefers full sun to light shade, so this spot near a vegetable garden is perfect for this shrub. These rosy pink flowers are extremely attractive to hummingbirds, butterflies, and of course, the bees. This shrub is low maintenance, but it does require some pruning in the fall. I love how the area where our vegetable garden is full of greenery in the spring, but a burst of light pink in the background with this plant. Now, this area might not look like anything exciting now, but in a few weeks, this area will be filled with various wildflowers, phlox, and sunflowers. Having flowers that pollinators love next to your vegetable garden is key to keep the bad bugs away to let your vegetables thrive. Alrighty, so I hope you guys enjoyed today's video of the garden tour from May to June. There were so many flowers that I couldn't fit in this video because there's new ones popping up every day. So next time we have a tour from June to July, there's going to be so many new ones. So can't wait till you guys see that. And next video, we're going to be tackling some garden and maintenance that needs to be done. And there's a lot that I need to catch you guys up on that's super important to know. So stay tuned for that. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for my next video.